something to eat, it's not a flu, it's not actually something to see. What is taqwa? You need to know what is taqwa in order to achieve it. If your mother or father or someone sent you in the market to get apples and you don't know what apples look like, how are you going to get apples? You'll wander all around the, maybe the full market of apples and you'll come back. You need to know what apples look like, what are they, otherwise you won't. So that's good enough, you know if they are called apples, but you also need to know what they are. If not, you should ask. Like if you want to know. So purpose of the existence of human being. In insan zindagi ka maqsad sabse bada is to serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is to worship Allah, be a being. Everyone, alhamdulillah, most people are aware of that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in that Surah Al-Baqarah, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ وَاعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Now the purpose of ibadah, so purpose of existence is taqwa, is ibadah. Now the purpose of ibadah is to attain taqwa, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, O mankind, worship your Lord who created you and the people, those before you, so that hopefully you will have taqwa. Yani zindagi ka maqsad to ibadat hua, aur ibadat ka maqsad jo Allah Pak ne bayan farmaya, wo hai taqwa. Now this is the means. Now the next question is that what will I achieve if I attain taqwa? Taqwa has, main karunga to kya mujhe milega, what will I attain? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentioned in the Quran, salvation and pleasure of Allah. Sabse badi cheez to Allah ki raza hai, sabse badi cheez. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, zawan min Allah akbar. Sabse badi cheez Allah ki raza hai. Why? Because if you have the raza of Allah, you have everything. When the people of Jannah will see the vision of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that day, Jannah. Jab jannati log Allah ka didar karenge, isse badi koi nemat nahi. To Allah ka farmayenge, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, my servants, are you happy? This is Allah Azza wa Jal, Ya Allah, Ya Ilaha Al-Ameen, you have saved us from the fire of hell, entered us in Jannah, blessed with your vision. What is more? Allah Azza wa Jal said, today I am going to give you a blessing which is even more greater than this. Aaj tumhe isse badi ne'mat dene wala hoon, aur bhi badi ne'mat hai. Main wo kya? Ki aaj ke baad main tumse naraaz nahi hoon. That I will not be displeased with you from now on. Why? Did Shaitan get in Jannah? Tell me. Kya Shaitan Jannah mein nahi kya? Hum chale gaye to chalo theek hai chale jayenge. Lekin Shaitan bhi to Jannah mein raha. Sayyid Adam Alaihi Salam bhi Jannah mein gaye. Shaitan ke saath Allah ki rida nahi rahi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was not there. So he again actually is living amongst us and also spoiling us and trying to drag us there where he is going. Because he did not have actually the rida. So Allah says, this is a great, this should be the purpose and the ultimate aim of the ibadat of the Muslim. The ibadat of the Muslim purpose is not actually to see a vision, to see a good dream, or to attain some supernatural power, or to attain money, or to walk on the fire, or to fly in the air. This is not the purpose of the ibadat of the Muslim. The purpose of the ibadat of the Muslim, ultimate aim is rida of Allah, but that can only be achieved by following Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. All other doors are closed altogether. Whoever will go open another door, he will be rejected. He will be rejected. Only one door is open. Rasulullah said in one of the hadith, even today people talk about that, shall we not follow other people? Why we need to follow Sunnah? We can. Rasulullah said, even if Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam was to appear in my Ummah, or Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam, they will have no other option but to follow me. فرمایا کہ اگر عیسیٰ ابن مریم اور موسیٰ علیہ السلام کلیم اللہ بھی میرے زمانے میں آ جائیں ان کو بھی نجات نہیں مل سکتی سوائے میری اطاعت و فرمان بردار تو ریفا اس لیے آئی ایم فالوئنگ دس لیڈر میں اس کو فالو کر رہا ہوں اس لیے مجھے مل جائے گی آئی ایم فالوئنگ بٹ واٹ فالوئنگ اینی ون ایلس ایون دا نبیز اینڈ انبیاء اینڈ رسل اینڈ پریکٹیکلی حضرت عیسیٰ علیہ السلام ول پروو دس ہی ول پروو دس وین ہی کمز نیئر دی ڈے آف ججمنٹ جب وہ آئیں گے he will be following the sunnah and the sharia of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Practically, there is no salvation without. So believe me, and this is the unanimous decision of all the Sufi-i Karam, that a person, Sayyidina Abai al-Hindustani rahmatullah said, a person can fly in the air, a person can read all your mind, what you are thinking, a person can turn dust and mud and clear stones into gold, a person can do anything, a person fly in the air. But if he is going against the sunnah of Rasulullah, he is shaitan, he is not a wali. آپ نے فرمایا کہ پھر وہ اگر وہ لوگوں کو پھر بھی یہ گناہ کہتا ہے کہ بھئی یہ چیزیں دیکھ کے بزرگی ملتی ہے تو فرمایا کہ وہ شیطان ہو سکتا ہے ولی نہیں ہو سکتا. ولایت, the definition of ولایت یہی ہے تقوا کی, کہ اوور مور ریزمبلز رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم, جتنی ہی آپ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم سے مشابہت ہو جائے آپ کی اتنی ہی بڑی ولایت ہے. میں نے آپ کو پہلے ہی بتایا, I have mentioned you first as well, حضرت ابو بکر شبلی رحمۃ اللہ علیہ, حضرت ابو بکر شبلی رحمۃ اللہ علیہ, the disciple and the Khalifa of Hazrat Junaid Baghdadi, when he was to die in Alam-e-Naza, in the throes of death, آپ جب Alam-e-Naza کے عالم میں تھے, آپ نے اپنے مرید سے فرمایا کہ اشارہ کیا کہ وضو کراؤ, that let me do وضو, and then he could not speak. This was his state. یہ آپ کی حالت تھی کہ بس چند سیکنڈوں بعد موت آنے والی تھی. It was like the death was going to come, and he could not speak at that time. So he said, he pointed, indicated, I want to do wudu. He did the wudu, the murid or the other disciple helped him to do wudu. But then he called them again after the wudu finished. And he held his hand and actually combed his beard with the wet hand. He said that this was the sunnah, which he could not speak, but they knew that this was the sunnah they missed actually when they were helping him. آپ اتنی سنت کے پابند کہ آپ نے موت کے وقت عالم نزا میں بھی فرمایا کہ جو خلال کی سنت ہے ابھی بھی میں اس کا ہاتھ لے کے وہ ادھر مارا اور پھر آپ کے روح ملیں گی. تو اس میں ثابت کیا حضرت جی نے بغدادی رحمۃ اللہ علیہ اینڈ حضرت بکر شبلی کہ اس کو ولایت کر دیں حضرت معین الدین چشتی رحمۃ اللہ علیہ. تو بی آؤٹ آف یور مائنڈ کمپلیٹلی اول ڈور دا کلوز ایکسیپٹ ایکلی رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم شریعہ یہ سننا ہز وے ایوری ون ول بی ریجیکٹڈ. I have given you the extreme example now that Rasulullah himself said, even Anbiya alayhi salam, if Hazrat Musa alayhi salam was to appear, he will also have to follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And on the day of judgment, you will see that they will be following. And they all followed on the night of Mi'raj, Rasulullah said, they followed Rasulullah. In night of Mi'raj, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave a khutbah. He did not only read the prayers, it comes in the hadith. Hadith mein aata hai, ki aapne namaz hi nahi padhai, Mi'raj ki raat, mujhe khutbah bhi diya. And in a detail, Rasulullah mentioned various other things. تو اس کو سمجھ لیں بڑی اچھی طرح. Now what does salvation mean? فلاح کا جو بتایا ہے یا رضا اس کا کیا مطلب ہے؟ You will be given an eternal life and how whatever you wish in the hereafter forever and ever and ever. بس یہ یہاں رہ کے being here you listen and obey Allah and His Messenger for a short while, 50 years, 60 years, and then forever and ever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, I will do whatever you say. پھر ہمیشہ ہمیشہ کے لیے میں بندے وہ کروں گا جو تو کہے گا, اب تھوڑی سے زمانے میں تم میری بات سمجھو. اور یہ بات بھی جو بندے نے سننی ہے, عبادت کرنی ہے, اس میں اللہ کا کوئی فائدہ نہیں, رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کا کوئی فائدہ نہیں. آپ کو تو جو مقام اللہ پاک نے آپ کو دے دیا وہ دے دیا, ساری کائنات سے پہلے دے دیا. Now his status is not going elevated because me and you do عبادت. But Rasulullah loves his ummah, that's why he wants us to follow him. Okay. Now, the other important question which comes in people's mind, how can I change my, how can I change? Khud hi tabdili aa jayegi mujh mein? Shall I, will I change, will I just be sleeping and living life as in normal routine and I will change? No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ, verily Allah will never change the condition of people until they change themselves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not change your condition until you have the concern to change it yourself. Because if Allah wanted to send you in paradise, why would have He sent you here all in this world? He would have created you and said, straight in Jannah, jao bhai maut karo. Is duniya mein Allah paak ne imtihan ke liye bheja hai. Agar waise hi Jannat Allah paak ne deni hai, to pehla agar usi ka Jannat mein like angels are living like who, bhoore reh rahi hai, aur kitni makhlooq Jannat mein jo reh rahi. But here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants me and you to change ourselves, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I will help you and I will give you your feet and sustain you and give you the blessing. So no one is going to change. Even the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, living a person, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the ocean of mercy and guidance. Aap hidayat aur rahmat ke darya hain, isse bada koi darya nahi. But those people who did not want to change, us waqt bhi jinhone kaha hum nahi maan mane